Welcome to the Fit Small Business Xero Training Course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to import products and services into Xero. To follow along with me, log into your Xero account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. In order to import your existing products and services into Xero, you should export this information from your old accounting software program to a CSV or Excel spreadsheet. It will make it much easier to copy the information into the products and services template we will download from Xero next. If your current accounting software program does not allow you to download your existing products and services list into a CSV or Excel format, then you will need to manually enter this information into the Xero import template. Once you have the list, you are ready to import the data into Xero. From the Accounts menu, we want to go ahead and go down to Inventory. And on the right here, we want to click Import and select Items. On this screen, in this first step here, download your items template file. We've got a link to an Excel template that we need to download to our computer. So go ahead and click on the download template link here to download this to your computer and be sure to name it and save it. An Excel spreadsheet similar to this one should have downloaded to your computer. As you will notice, there are a total of 12 columns. The only required column is this first column, item code. However, we recommend that you complete as much information as possible in the template so that you don't have to manually enter it later on. One other thing that I'd like for you to note is columns 3, 4, 5, and 6 are related to items that you purchase. So for example, if you plan to send purchase orders and you want to save items that you order frequently, then you want to go ahead and complete these columns. Columns 7, 8, 9, and 10 are only for items that you sell. The information that is entered into these columns will appear on quotes, invoices, and credit notes that you send to customers. So let's go ahead and talk about the item code field. This is the only required field, as I mentioned. If you have a UPC or an SKU, then you should enter that information here as your item code. A combination of numbers and letters can be entered in this field up to a maximum of 30 characters. Item codes help you to organize and quickly locate items to complete forms like invoices and purchase orders. The item name field includes a brief description of the item. This is the internal description field for the item and not the one that your customers and suppliers will see. Purchase description includes the description that you want your suppliers to see on purchase orders. If you don't use purchase orders, you can leave this field blank. Purchases unit price includes the agreed upon cost of the item in this field. This will pre-fill on purchase orders that you create and send to suppliers. You can always edit the unit price when you create the purchase order if you need to. Purchases account. If you are setting up an item that you keep track of quantities and cost for, also known as a tracked item, then leave this field blank. Xero will use the code in the cost of goods sold column to keep track of purchases. However, if you are setting up an item that you do not track quantity and cost for, known as an untracked item, then enter the account code in this field that you use for purchases. To learn more about tracked and untracked items, click this link. Please note that you need to be sure to enter the account code and not the account description in these account field. For example, if your purchases account is 5050, you don't want to enter purchases in this field, but instead you would enter 5050, so just the code. If you enter anything other than the code in this field, this information will not import into Xero. Purchases tax rate. If applicable, assign the appropriate tax rate to each item. In the How to Set Up Tax Rates lesson, we discussed how to manage sales tax rates. Click this link to access this lesson. Sales description. include the description that you want customers to see on their invoices in this column. Be as descriptive as possible so that your customer knows exactly what you are invoicing them for. Sales unit price. Include the price that you charge your customers for the item. This will appear on customer invoices and receipts. If pricing varies by customer, you can leave this field blank and complete it when you create the invoices, quotes, and receipts to your customers. Sales account. Enter the chart of accounts code that you use to track sales of the item. In the How to Set Up a Chart of Accounts lesson, we covered how to add accounts. Click this link to access this lesson. Similar to the purchases account, you want to make sure that you're just entering the code for the account as we have done here. Sales tax rate. Enter the sales tax rate for each item in this field. If the item is not taxable, be sure to select the tax exempt option. In the How to Set Up Sales Tax lesson, we discussed how to set up and track sales tax. Click this link to access this lesson. Inventory asset account. If you are setting up an untracked item, you can leave this field blank. However, if you are setting up a tracked item, then enter the account code that you use to track inventory. If you are using the default chart of accounts in Xero, then the inventory asset account is automatically included on your chart of accounts. However, if you imported an existing chart of accounts from another accounting software over the default chart of accounts in Xero, then you will need to add an inventory asset account before you can import this template. In the How to Set Up a Chart of Accounts lesson, we walk through the steps on how to add an account. You can click this link to access this lesson. Cost of Goods Sold account. If you are setting up an untracked item, you can leave this column blank. However, if you are setting up a tracked item, enter the account code that you use to track cost of goods sold. If you are using the default chart of accounts in Xero, then the cost of goods sold account is automatically included on your chart of accounts. On the other hand, if you imported an existing chart of accounts from another accounting software over the default chart of accounts in Xero, then you will need to add a cost of goods sold account in Xero before you can import this template. Head over to our How to Set Up a Chart of Accounts in Xero lesson to add the necessary accounts and then come back to complete this template. Click here to access this lesson. Be sure that you enter the account code in this field and not the account description, as we have discussed for the sales account and the purchases account columns. If you enter anything other than the code, this information will not import into Xero. Once you have completed the items template, save it in a CSV format. Before we start the import, some tips on formatting your import file. Tip number one, do not make any changes or delete the header row. So make sure that your template always includes this row here, which is your header row. Tip number two, do not change the order of the columns. Tip number three, the item code field, this very first column, is required. You cannot leave this field blank for any item or the import will not work. Tip number four, you can import up to 1,000 items at one time. If you have more than 1,000 items, you can put them on a separate template and import the remaining items or enter them individually. Tip number five, be sure to enter the account code only and not the description as we've discussed. Four, the purchases account field, the sales account field, inventory asset account column, and the cost of goods sold column. I cannot say that or stress that enough. Now let's return to the import screen so we can import our data. Let's go ahead and navigate over to accounts and inventory. And let's click the import button and select items. So if you scroll down, Let's go ahead and click on Browse and locate our file. Once you have located your file and selected it, you should see the file name to the right here of the Browse button. And once you have that file, you can go ahead and click Continue. In this next screen, Xero will provide you with a summary of the total number of items that will be created or updated. If there are any errors with your file, you will also be notified what those errors are and specifically what needs to be fixed in this screen as well. This is your final opportunity to review the number of inventory items that will be created or updated in Xero for the import. If you are happy with what you see here and you are ready to proceed with the import, go ahead and click Complete Import. If for some reason there is errors or your spreadsheet does not agree with the number of accounts that you see here, then you want to go ahead and click the back button. So we'll go ahead and click Complete Import. And now our inventory items have been imported into Xero. That wraps up the lesson on how to import products and services into Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.